Hello everyone. The title of today's lecture is Heat Engine, Refrigerator and Heat Pump. In this video lecture, following points will be covered. First, thermal reservoir, source, sink. Second, heat engine, thermal efficiency of heat engine. Third, heat pump, refrigerator, coefficient of performance of heat pump and refrigerator. So first of all, we'll define the thermal reservoir or heat reservoir. A hypothetical body with a relatively large thermal energy capacity, that is mass into specific heat, that can supply or absorb finite amounts of heat without undergoing any change in temperature, such a body is called a thermal energy reservoir or is just a reservoir. So for example, the atmosphere and the ocean. So what is important here? So even if you add the some heat into the atmosphere, its temperature will not increases. Or even if some amount of heat is added in the ocean, the temperature is not going to be changed. So we can consider the atmosphere and ocean as a thermal energy reservoir. Next, a source. How will define the source? A reservoir that supplies energy in the form of heat is called a source, and a reservoir that absorbs energy in the form of heat is called as a sink. So next, we all know that doing work on a water will generate the heat. So if shaft is rotating, it converts into heat. However, transferring heat to liquid will not generate work. So whether this heat which is supplied to the water will be able to rotate this shaft, so there will be no work. So the reverse process is not possible. It doing so does not violate the first law, as long as the heat added to the water is the same as the work gained by the shaft. So this process is not possible spontaneously or by its own. Previous example leads to the concept of heat engine. We have seen that work always converts directly and completely to heat, but converting heat to work requires the use of some special devices. These devices are called heat engines. So what are the characteristics of heat engines? So here, the first characteristic is that they receive heat from a high temperature source. So here is the source. It receives the heat Q in from the high temperature source. Next, they convert part of this heat to work. They convert part of this into work. They rejects the remaining waste heat to a low temperature sink. They rejects the some heat to the low temperature sink. And most important, they operate on a thermodynamic cycle. So can you save the Q out? Okay, so it is it possible? Let us will see that. We'll consider the gas inside the cylinder whose temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, and the heat is added. How much amount of heat is added? The heat in, that is 100 kilojoules. 100 kilojoules is heated added to the gas from the 100 degrees Celsius reservoir, so that because of this, the gas will expand and it does the work equal to 15 kilojoules. 15 kilojoules work is done by the system on the surrounding, and thereby the temperature of gas increases to 90 degrees Celsius. Now it reaches to the state 2. Okay, how can you go back to get more weights, that is complete the cycle? So if we want to take the another weight, so we cannot, that is possible by rejecting the heat, that is 85 kilojoules, in order to come back to the original state. So how much heat is added? 100 kilojoules. Out of that, 50 kilojoules work has been done. So in order to come back this system into original state, so 85 kilojoules amount of heat has to be rejected to the any reservoir. Okay, so can you reject it to the hot reservoir, that is 100 degrees Celsius? So 90 degrees Celsius gas temperature, the gas heat cannot be transferred to the 100 degrees Celsius. So what do we need? I need cold reservoir to reject the 85 kilojoules. So we required a low temperature reservoir. So what is the conclusion? A heat engine cycle cannot be completed without rejecting some heat to a low temperature sink. So conclusion is that we cannot save the Q out. So we need to waste some energy, okay, to the low temperature sink. Next, what are the examples of the heat engine? So piston cylinder arrangement is an example of the heat engine. So here gas is considered, it expands by adding the heat and it reaches to this state and it rejects the heat to the low temperature sink and again coming back to its original state. Now by doing this, the work will get and the cycle, thermodynamic cycle has been completed. Now another example is a steam power plant is another example of heat engine, wherein the water is converted into steam by supplying the some amount of heat into the water. Then steam expands in the turbine, we get W out, and the steam is condensed, that is converted into liquid state, liquid water. So that is in the condenser by rejecting Q out, and pump increases the pressure from low pressure to the high pressure by taking the W in. Okay, so now the thermodynamic cycle has been completed. So here the W net output is nothing but W out minus W in. So here turbine produces W out amount of work and it takes W in. So how much is the net work? Net work is always equal to W out minus W in. So a portion of work output of a heat engine is consumed internally to maintain the continuous operation. Now the thermal efficiency of the heat engine, how will define it's the thermal efficiency? The fraction of heat input that is converted to net work output is a measure of the performance of a heat engine and is called the thermal efficiency. So here again W net is equal to W out minus W in. So the fraction of heat input means here, so whatever the heat is supplied, so out of that some amount of W net is produced and some amount of heat will be rejected. So how much fraction of heat input is converted into W net? So that fraction is called as a thermal efficiency. Now here if you consider the example here, thermal efficiency of the first engine, 100 kilojoules it takes in, and the net work is obtained by the first engine is 20 kilojoules. So out of 100, 20 kilojoules means 20 divided by 100 is the 20% is the conversion efficiency, whereas 80 kilojoules out of 100 is rejected to the sink. The second engine, it takes 100 kilojoules, but out of 100, 30 kilojoules is converted into network and remaining 70 kilojoules is wasted. So how much is the thermal efficiency? That is 30 divided by 100, that is a 30%. Like this, we can calculate the thermal efficiency of heat engine. So thermal efficiency is equal to W net upon net output divided by Q in. Since W net is equal to Q in minus Q out for the cyclic process, so we can replace this W net here in this equation. And finally, we got the expression thermal efficiency is equal to 1 minus Q out divided by Q in. Now, if you consider our example, heat is transferred to a heat engine from a furnace at a rate of 80 megawatt. If the rate of waste heat rejection to a nearby river is 50 megawatt, determine the net power output and the thermal efficiency for this heat engine. So how much heat is added? At what rate the heat is added? 80 megawatt from the source, that is a furnace. Out of that, 50 megawatt is the rate of heat rejection to the river, that at the sink. So how much is the net power output? So net power output is equal to input heat minus output heat. So that is 80 minus 50. So that is equal to 30. Okay. So 30 is the W net. And how much is the thermal efficiency? Thermal efficiency is equal to this W net, that is 30 divided by 80. So answer is, that is 30 megawatt. And this 30 divided by 80 comes 0.375, means 37.5% is the thermal efficiency. Like this, we can calculate the thermal efficiency of the heat engine. Now, what is the working fluid? Working fluid is a heat engine and other cyclic devices usually involve a fluid to and from which heat is transferred while undergoing a cycle. This fluid is called the working fluid. Here, the working fluid in this steam power plant is the water. Okay, so water changes, water takes the heat in the boiler and it does the work in the turbine, and it rejects the heat in the condenser and its pressure will be increases in the pump. So water is the working fluid in the steam power plant. Now the refrigerator, how will define the refrigerator? The transfer of heat from a low temperature medium to a high temperature one requires a special devices called refrigerators. Refrigerators like heat engines are cyclic devices. The working fluid used in the refrigeration cycle is called as a refrigerant. The most frequently used refrigeration cycle is the vapor compression refrigeration cycle, which involves four main components: a compressor, a condenser, an expansion valve, and an evaporator. So these components are shown here. Okay, so here the evaporator is here, then compressor, the working fluid here is the refrigerant which passes through these tubes. Okay, and it enters in the evaporator, then it enters in the compressor, then condensation occurs, then expansion valve, again it is coming back. So it is a cyclic device. Okay, so basic component of a refrigeration system and typical operating conditions are given in this diagram. So it consists of the four major components: evaporator, compressor, condenser, and the expansion valve. So let us will understand this, what happens in the individual component. And so in the evaporator, low pressure, low temperature, the refrigerant which passes through this blue color pipe, and it its temperature is very less, around minus 25 degrees Celsius. It takes the heat from the refrigerated space whose temperature is to be maintained below atmosphere. So because of temperature difference, here temperature is of the refrigerant is less and the temperature of this refrigerator is more, so there will be the heat transfer, and it changes the refrigerant, changes the phase from liquid to vapor. Now this vapor are compressed in the compressor from low pressure to high pressure. In the high pressure, next is the condenser, wherein the high pressure vapors are passing through this and it rejects the heat to the surrounding air and it converted into liquid state. Now this high pressure liquid is expanded from high pressure, that is 800 kilopascal, to the low pressure, and the temperature also decreases in the expansion valve, okay, and it again come back to its original state. So now the cycle has been completed. So this is how the refrigerators works. Now the coefficient of performance of the refrigerator. So if you want to evaluate the performance of the heat engine, we have used the thermal efficiency. Now in order to evaluate the performance of the refrigerator, we use the coefficient of refrigerator. So here the efficiency of a refrigerator is expressed in terms of the coefficient of performance, denoted by COPR. Now COPR is equal to, what is the formula for this? It is a ratio of desired output, what we want, and how much is the required input. So what is the desired output here for the refrigerant? How much heat should be taken out from the refrigerated space to maintain the temperature TL at the desired value? Okay, so at what rate should be heat should be taken out, so from the refrigerated space, so that is the desired output. And for this, achieving this, how much W net is required? So that ratio is called as the COP. Now the conservation of energy principle for a cyclic device requires, since it is a cyclic device, W in is equal to QH minus QL. So by keeping this value, we'll get this expression. So this W net is equal to QH minus QL. So we'll get 1 upon QH upon QL minus 1. Now the heat pump, another device that transfers heat from a low temperature medium to a high temperature one, is the heat pump. Refrigerators and heat pumps operate on the same cycle but differ in their objectives. The objective of a refrigerator is to maintain the refrigerated space at a low temperature by removing heat from it. Discharging this heat to a high temperature medium is merely a necessary part of the operation, not the purpose. The objective of a heat pump, however, is to maintain a heated space at high temperature. So both works on the same principle, okay, whereas the objective is different. So for the heat pump, the objective is to maintain the higher temperature at a constant temperature. Okay, so in order to maintain this high temperature with respect to the surrounding air temperature, surrounding temperature is 4 degrees Celsius. Now, in order to increase the temperature of this home, so how much heat should be added? So objective is here, at what rate the heat should be added to the this room to increase the temperature from 4 to 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, so that this is accomplished by absorbing heat from a low temperature source such as the well water or cold outside air in winter and supplying this heat to the high temperature medium such as a house. Now the coefficient of performance of the heat pump. So here the definition will remain same. The measure of performance of a heat pump is also expressed in terms of the coefficient of performance COP of HP, defined as the desired output again divided by required input. So here desired output is how much heat should be added so as to maintain this temperature at the desired value. Okay, and how much is the required input is required, that remain same in the denominator. So the according to the conservation of energy principle for a cyclic device requires that W net is equal to QH minus QL. By keeping this in this expression, we get this 1 upon 1 minus QL upon QH. Now if you compare this two heat pump and refrigerator which works on the same principle, though if you consider the heat pump, okay, so heat pump has the COP is equal to desired output upon required input. So this is the desired output and this is the required heat input. And the conservation principle, the W net is equal to QH minus QL. COP of heat pump is equal to this formula QH upon QH minus QL is equal to 1 upon 1 minus QL upon QH. Whereas the refrigerator, okay, refrigerator, the components are remain same, but objective here is, the objective is desired output is how much heat should be taken out from the refrigerated space to maintain the this temperature at the desired value. Okay, so the COP of refrigerator is desired output is QL divided by W net. Now that by keeping this value, so QL upon QH minus QL, that is equal to 1 upon QH by QL minus 1. So if you compare these two, we'll get this at a glance, the comparison of heat pump and the refrigerator. So what is the relationship between the COP of the refrigerator and the COP of the heat pump? So COP of heat pump is given by QH upon W net in. So where QH upon W net in is equal to QH minus QL is also written is equal to. So this can be written, this QH is nothing but, so W net in plus QL divided by QH minus QL. Okay. So the conservation energy principle for cyclic device requires that W net in is equal to QH minus QL. So this QH is expressed, QH is equal to W net this plus QL. From this equation we can write down this. Now this COP of heat pump is equal to, so by splitting this, W net in divided by QH minus QL plus QL upon QH minus QL, that gives us 1 plus COP of refrigerator. So that is COP of heat pump is equal to 1 plus COP of refrigerator. Okay, so we'll stop here. Thank you.